why would you invest in commodities? Why would you touch gold or even silver in a situation like that? What's the benefit of having that? Because we've already discussed the fact that people generally don't have that in their portfolios. I think everyone here who's a Bitcoiner or into crypto at least superficially understands why you would. But these returns in these situations are remarkable. We're talking about here, commodities do very well during war periods. From the time of Pearl Harbor until the end of the war, commodities delivered a 100% return, right?
Yeah, 100% real return too. And so I think that that is, commodities basically in conflicts, there's a limited supply of, you know, physical assets that go into the production of, you know, of armaments that are used during a wartime period, as well as the fuel necessary to accomplish it. And during a wartime period, basically everyone is scrambling to get their hands on those resources. The US is in a good position structurally along those dimensions, but it doesn't mean that there isn't a price squeeze on those assets. And that's essentially what we see here, which is when you take a diversified portfolio of commodities, basically all commodities go up during a wartime period. And that's essentially what we've seen, you know, in a much smaller way over the course of the last 10 days or so following the rising conflict in the Mideast.
Right. Obviously, we talked quite a bit already about the 60-40 here. In any longer term perspective, this multi-decade period of low conflict is extremely unusual. Obviously, that's talking about now, right? So we've really yes. had sort of an unprecedented time, and we still do, guys, to be frank, right? This is a regional war, again, much like Ukraine and Russia for now, but this is actually an unprecedented time of peace that we've really had.
Yeah, I mean, I found that chart to be very interesting, a 600-year perspective on the amount of conflict, the amount of global conflict, and just how extremely low that has been over the last 30 or 40 years. In many ways, most of us probably don't even appreciate that it is so low, because it's basically been that way during our, you know, the entire time of our, you know, formative professional careers, as well as our lives. And that in any context, you would certainly not expect to see even lower global conflict, or would want to necessarily bet on even lower global conflict. And what I'd emphasize here, this is not what I'm, what we're talking about here is not a view that there will be no particular insight. Cause I frankly don't think that I certainly don't have any particular insight in whether there'll
Neither.
Be more or less conflict in the future. It's just recognizing that 60-40 is an all-in bet on no conflict, and there's likely to be some conflict in the future that you want to protect yourself against in the case that you see that.